folks. It's 6:23 in the morning. I am at SFO. I have prepared myself for the flight with the following. Box of saltines. That was a last minute decision. I saw them. I was like, gotta have them. Some ginger ale, because my stomach kind of feels upset right now. But I think it's actually because I still have cramps. So I picked up some Midol. It took me going to like three different places to find this. And then it's not a flight out of Terminal 2 in SFO unless I get me some Annie's Cheddar Bunnies and Benny Graham's. I'm exhausted and I got about 2 hours of sleep, so I'm fingers crossed that I sleep on the plane. I just had the most comically bad flight experience ever, which helps me go to the toilet like every 10 minutes. I don't even know if you can hear me because I'm trying to talk very quietly as I exit the plane. It's terrible. Oh my god, my stomach hurts. Overpriced airport store to the rescue.
The final stop for this train will be Jamaica Station.
The first whiff of the cold, cold air. I'm in a tiny elevator that is bright. 14th floor, I feel like I'm gonna barf. Wonderful travel day. Hey guys, want a hotel room tour? Well, this is the pod hotel, so it's a fucking tiny pod. I love it. I'm a den animal. I like being in tiny little dens. It's also great price, cheap. There, that's my entire room. Literally, you walk in and you're like, oh, hello, little tiny bed. Hello, window. Hello, tiny desk. Hello, like, prison sink. Toilet. Shower. Closet. I mean, what more do you need? What do I need to do right now? Change my tamp. Sit on the toilet for a hot minute because I was not feeling good. And I might have to like go find a fucking Sephora and buy a strainer because I forgot mine. And eat something because I really haven't eaten today besides for like 4 saltines and ginger ale. Okay, we can do this. I have so much shit to do this week. Ah, can't be sick. So if you know me, you know I'm super organized and tidy. Your beard looks really cute.
No, thanks. I feel like it's very full lately.
I like your hairdo too. Your hair looks very nice and messy.
You like my hair up.
Like, yeah.
You like it on the side, it looks fucking crazy like that.
No, that looks good. I like it when your hair looks like you've been electrocuted.
It's the Bernie Sanders in me is coming out. That's what you're liking.
Here I am in my hotel room. It's getting later. And I feel shitty for, I'm like, I'm in New York City. I just got here. And I feel shitty for sitting in here. And it's making me feel anxious that I'm not like out doing something, enjoying it. But I have so much shit to do the next couple of days that I'm trying to tell myself, no, you're totally fine. Just sit here, plan out your week so that way you're relaxed, eat some food, rest. That bitch seems crazy. Ted Cruz is talking, so but I'm gonna make a list of all the stores I wanna go to in New York.
So Saturday tomorrow, I have an appointment at Stephen Allen Showroom. I'm going to go to Market 35, which is a really small trade show of about maybe 10 brands, but I carry a couple of them, and it's a great little, like, concentrated, well-curated show. And then I'm going to Woman, which is larger, but still a small trade show. And I really like that one. Very, like, high-end, nice brands. Some international stuff, too. And then Sunday is going to be the biggest day. That's going to be Capsule and Axis, and they're just really big. So they take from, like, 10 a.m. to, like, 4 or 5 p.m. for me to go through them, because I stop at every single booth and look at every single thing. And then on Monday, I'm going to go to Coterie, which really is not the scene necessarily for the store. That's more of like a department store, and Nordstrom would go there. But there is a showroom of mine that I visit when I'm in LA, and they're going to be at Coterie. And so I'll see some shoes and some clothes, like mainly like the Australian stuff, like Keepsake and Solson and whatnot. So that'll be at Coterie. Brand Assembly is good. I went to that in LA for the first time. In, what was it, September I went to LA? Or October? I don't even remember when that was. But anyway, so I went to Brand Assembly. It's nice. Totally the vibe. Very much like a Capsule. And then DNA I've never gone to, but I'm curious about it, so I'm going to check that out. So I leave on the 23rd on Tuesday, and hopefully I find some time for shopping and exploring stores and stuff myself. I don't think I'm gonna leave Manhattan. I'm probably not going to Brooklyn at all. I was hoping to go to a museum, but there's really just not enough time with all these things that I gotta do. So Tuesday I can check out, leave my bag at the hotel, and try to take some time for myself. Like, it's just gonna be exactly what I'm doing every day. I'm gonna be looking at clothes.
Just going on a dinner date with myself and no one else, because I'm all by myself. Here's my long commute to where I'm gonna eat dinner, because last time I stayed here, I went to this restaurant and it was really good. So I said, I'm gonna try to go here again. And hopefully it doesn't have a fucking line.
So now I'm just walking around in the neighborhood that I'm staying, because it's such like perfect East Coast cold that I just want to walk around in it so bad. And it feels nice. And I'm bored. My eyes are so underwater. Serving up a girl with a dragon tattoo with realness all over the New York City streets.
Look at this like moody Batman shot.
Of all the things to look at in New York, this is what draws my attention. What an interesting task. I could watch this guy put up this sign for like an hour. He's made a lot of progress since I walked by him before. So cool. ASMR.
Yeah, measure how far apart those letters gotta be.
Oh, better straighten that ruler, mister. Mark that line.
When I was in New York in September, I laid in bed at the Pod 51 Hotel and watched Republicans debate on CNN. I mean, this is a town hall, so it's a little different, but like, life does not change. I don't agree with Jeb Bush politically, but I don't know what it is about him. I find him to be kind of adorable. I'm losing it, right? Like, Jeb Bush is like so adorable, I just want to give him a big old smooch. Okay, not that, not when he's talking about the Lord and Savior. But when he smiles, he has a funny mouth.
So I just painted my nails, and I only fucked up this one because I was on the phone with Ryan when I was doing it, and he made me laugh. So thanks a fucking lot, Ryan. I hear people. Get the fuck out of the hallway, you crazies. Get out of here. Good morning. I need a bagel and some breakfast before I think about getting ready for my first appointment for the day. So, going to Esta Bagel.
Just kidding, my hotel has a cafe that sells Esta Bagels, so my ass ain't leaving the building.
Okay guys, market week, day one. I'm actually pretty early for the day. I
wasn't sure if I was gonna be like tired or whatever, so I planned my first appointment to be at 2 p.m., but I think I'm actually gonna go to one of the trade shows before my 2 p.m. appointment, because it's only like 11:30 right now. And I'm sorry, but there's no full-length mirror for me to do my outfit of the day in, so you just have to like, I'm wearing a scarf shop, scarf from Anomi in Iceland. Fuck, what's that color called from the Spider-Man OPI collection? It'll be down in the description box. I'm wearing the new Boss ring from Winden by Anomi. The Boss necklace is under there. Oh, and a Drift Riot collar is under there too. This is from ASOS. I've got the Garance Dore Nordstrom collab. I've just got like a Gap shirt, and then I've got Zara pants, and I don't know what I'm doing. Doc Martin boots. Okay. So that's my outfit of the day, and yeah, I'm gonna go to the trade show now. See, I'm excited. I am on my way to Market 35. I gotta get on the 6 to Canal Street. Anytime I think of being on the 6, I think of Jennifer Lopez. Hey, you can kind of see my outfit now. Boop. Hopefully there's nobody on the other side of this mirror that's like, what the fuck is this bitch doing? Milky Jelly Chelsea. I actually just spotted them. I'm not going there. I'm not that cool. I am going that way. Okay, just went into Reformation, which everyone always loves, but I don't know, I just never really find anything for me, and I'm gonna go into opening ceremony right now. Then I'm gonna go a couple floors up, and that's where my showroom is. No elevators. Okay, so I'm precariously walking down a stairwell right now, but I'm just leaving Market 35, where I saw a bunch of brands, and I kind of feel weird about like doing my like dumb, shitty, like personal vlogs in like such a work environment. So I'm not gonna be probably taking the vlogs to actually show you like the legit things, because you know, work-life balance. But yeah, so now I'm gonna run over to the Stephen Allen showroom and look at Odette and a hat brand and Claire V. I got my purse stuck in the door. Bagel break. It's like the perfect weather. It's beautiful here. I'm so happy. Hey guys, just got out of my meeting. Anomi's flagship store is actually gonna be opening at Broadway and Howard, so stay tuned. So I like to pretend these are go-sees, like America's Next Top Model. I'm like, oh my god, I have to go to my next go-see. And I am almost here. It's 3 o'clock and I think I maybe said I was maybe gonna go to Woman today, but then I don't think it's going on today, I don't know. So I'm gonna look and maybe go to Brand Assembly after I eat some food, because I'm hungry. And yeah, that's gonna be the rest of my, but I also am in Soho right now, so maybe I should just like kind of shop around a little bit, maybe for an hour. I think I might check out some stores. Time for a wacky clothes try on. Fuck. I just spent $1,100 at Stephen Allen and I just paid off that credit card. I had racked up so much money on my credit card when I opened Anomi. I bought all like the fixtures and stuff on my personal cards and I had just fucking paid that off, and now I'm just like, I hate having a balance on it anyway, so better make some sales this month. But it's like the coolest art teacher ensemble. I mean, you saw it. It was amazing. I couldn't not. Okay, well, I'm gonna go to the Rachel Comey store, I think. Even though I have no more money to spend on anything. This is like, this is what you have to do in New York. You have to do like one big splurgy splurge. And it's like, I could have easily spent like $200 on like stuff from like 5 different stores. I'm trying to justify. an escalator equals stairs, but I feel like so weird walking down them. Like, I'm afraid it's gonna turn on and I'm gonna fall. This is weird. They're also like higher than normal steps. Oh god, this is so precarious. I'm gonna try on this rag and bone top because it's super cute and it would go with all my Rachel Comey stuff. And then I'm going like a fucking bitch. I'm getting my hair done at the dry bar because I forgot a straightener. And instead of buying a straightener, why don't I just pay someone to do my hair? Ooh, wait, hit stop. I've been wanting to try out Mother Denim. The straight up, no tank ya. The Manhattan, no tank ya. The Cosmo, I mean, not if it's for my short hair like that. The Mai Tai. I mean, I like that if I had long hair, but with the short hair one, it might be a little too curly for what I'm going, but I like messy, beachy hair. The Cosmo tie. No, thank you. The Dirty Martini. I think this might be it. Except I hope it doesn't make my hair all like sticky and grossly textured, so. And there's the Southern Comfort. And the Turn It Up Teeny. Great. The key is they give you wine, so you go, oh my god, my hair looks so good because you've gotten drunk while they were doing your hair. Why do I feel anxious waiting for this to happen? Here I am with my Dirty Martini blowout, which is, this is actually exactly what I needed because I know my hair and this is gonna fall out into like what I was hoping to get. but she was like, right when I saw your face, I knew you were gonna do the Dirty Martini because the rest of my hair. But anyway, so yeah, that's the hairdo. It was $57 because it's like $47 and I gave the girl $10. But it's a great thing if you're just like not feeling like washing your hair. I'm gonna have to make a shower cap out of a plastic bag that I find in the hotel room for when I shower tomorrow morning. But yeah, and also Jeb Bush dropped out of the fucking GOP race. I'm so frightened. And like every single Republican candidate who wins New Hampshire and South Carolina goes on to get the nomination, and Donald Trump has won South Carolina and New Hampshire. So, holy shit, he very well might get the nomination. This is so frightening. I feel like an idiot just talking to myself on the street. People are walking by. Okay, bye. Bad blow bar bouncy curls leaving as well. Girl, brush them curls out. You'll look better. Oh shit, I hope they didn't hear me. Anyways, okay, I need to go home. Where in this Duane Reade do you think they sell tall socks? I need some socks because I only like could find one. I did however many loads of laundry I said I did, and I couldn't find a fucking pair of long socks besides one. So I wore short socks yesterday and long socks today, and I'm fresh out. I don't want stinky ass feet. I should also get snacks for tonight. I already ate dinner. I'm not gonna go back out. Okay, snacks now. Maybe some saltines too. I also love that, like, I don't think saltines is a brand of cracker. It's premium are the ones I eat. I eat premium saltine crackers, but I'm always like, yo, saltine, sponsor me. I don't think saltine exists. Does it exist? Anyways, saltine, sponsor me. Any of you, I'll even take nice saltine crackers. Yay, this one has socks. Okay, which Duane Reade, that I'm drawn to these guys. Boom. Don't mind if I do. Cotton socks from Duane Reade. I'm a boss. And a treat for my belly and a treat for my earsies. And now I'm just wandering around hoping that they have the nice yogurt pretzels. And I think I'm SOL. Shiza. Happiness is walking around Manhattan, a beautiful 60 degree day with some chocolate donuts you bought on sale because they're about to expire with your wacky dry bar blowout. Living the life. And we're back home in our little pod. By the way, does this seem like it's saying have sex? Store your stuff, remove the bed cover, grab those pod pillows, and start the fun. Please don't condone and encourage sex to occur in these rooms. That's just asking for a mess in your sheets, and I don't want to sleep in this bed after they did. I say do not disturb. I hate when people come in and like clean my room, so I'm the person who like never has housekeeping come the entire time. Finish those donuts. They were good. Okay, can I explain to you guys
my day. Here, hold on. I need to put everything down and, like, let me regroup and I'll come back.
Okay, let me explain my day, because I think I started vlogging in the middle of the day and then I just had so much shit I was carrying around. Kind of like didn't really vlog that much. Then I kind of brought it back up again when I got bored. Okay, so my day went as follows in case I missed any parts. Excuse me, I have to burp. Much better. Okay, so I woke up, I went to Market 35, which I told you, I think I showed you guys, and I was like, I don't like want to film in there. It's like feels weird and douchey. It's always confusing to me because it's like, yeah, I know I can take pictures and do all these things, but it's like most of the time it's like a buyer is doing that like for their own reference and things. So I don't know like what I can like put out into the world because these are collections that are coming out in the fall, or if they want to be more secretive. Like, I don't know. So I just like, don't even ask. So after I went to Market 35, I went to the Stephen Allen showroom, which was great. So I saw Odette and I was able to pull the stuff from spring that I had seen when I was in LA in October, I think it was. But then like I lost the line sheet and then like forgot about it. And so then so I'm gonna order a delayed spring order. And then I pulled for the fall collection as well, which is super beautiful. I love Odette so much. So that was great. And then I went back upstairs in the showroom and saw Claire V and Janessa Leone hats. And then I went back downstairs because they were like, oh, you might like this collection. And there was one that I liked, so I need to look at that further. But excited about Claire V as well for the fall. There's going to be two deliveries and there's going to be some really beautiful, fun stuff. And like some funkier things and like bringing in some pops of color and whatnot. So that's great. And then I was like thinking I was going to go to Woman, and I did all my planning last night. And I'm pretty sure that Woman was going on today, but maybe not. Maybe I fucked up my one task of the night last night. And so one of the girls was like, oh, Woman's not gonna be going today. So I was like, oh, fuck it then. So it was my all about me day where I just was like, I'm already in Soho. Like, instead of trying to like scoot back and come back here at a different time, I just went all around Soho to like all the stores I wanted to go to, and I was like, I had such a fun time. So what stores did I go to, you might be asking? Well, first off, I put a thing out on Instagram like, y'all tell me the stores you go to, because like I was total in a mind fart blank of like, what were the things that like Haley and I had put down on a list when we went last February? Like, I just want to go to all those stores again. And I forgot that Totokio had opened, and this girl Jen that I went to high school with, my friend, she was like, go to the Totokio. And I was like, duh. Okay, so that was on my list. And then I just popped into Stephen Allen first because that store is near the showroom and it's just like half a block away. So I went in and I was just like, oh, I don't know, like, sure, why not? Let's just like pull some funky things and try on some crazy items. Art teacher realness. I ended up getting that entire outfit. The pants in size 2 from Rachel Comey I bought, and they had a little like stain on him, but she got it out with Shout. It was just like dirt from the whatever room. So she's like, as terrible as it sounds, like, sorry, sometimes things get dirty. And I was like, girl, I understand. I was like, I have a store in San Francisco. People are fucking gross. They do gross things to clothes. Like, I've had things that I've had to basically sell at cost and tell people they're on super discount because people have fucked them up. Like, I get it. No worries here. So I bought the pants. They didn't have a size 0, but the size 2 fit really well. So I was like, okay, cool. And then later on in the day, like, I was going to a bunch of different stores, and I went into the Rachel Comey store because I was like, fuck it. Like, why don't I just see what the 0s are like, because they had a 0. And lo and behold, the fucking 0s fit like better than the 2s, because it's an insane pant. Like, they're super crazy wide, but the 0 like just kind of harnessed it in a little bit. It sat higher on the waist, and in comparison I was like, fuck, mama wants the 0, not the 2. And it's a, when it comes down to after tax, this is a $420 pant we're talking about here, people. Yeah, gonna get the right one. So I look at the receipt, and of course it's like store credit only. So I was like, fuck, but whatever, I can obviously spend $420 at Stephen Allen. So I bought the Rachel Comey pants. You gotta see the little, yeah, see, I bought the Rachel Comey pants at the Rachel Comey store, and then I had 2 pairs of fucking insane Rachel Comey pants on my body when I have like never owned a pair before and had dreamed about them for so long. So I was like, this is just like a funny moment right now. Like, how the fuck do I do? Of course I know how I got them, because I'm a psycho. I really should not have bit the bullet. Like, the Rachel Comey store was so close to the Stephen Allen store. I shouldn't have said like, let me think about it, like, I'll come back. But no, I just bought them right then and there, which is fine, you know. I felt like I was putting good shopping karma into the world, because then I was talking to Jen all day and the store was doing really good in San Francisco. So I was like, yeah, I'm getting karma, like, woo, throw some money out, get some money back. That's how it works. So then I went back to Stephen Allen and I returned the pants, actually to a different store. Cause they have so many fucking stores. Why do they have so many stores? Well, there was one like 10 minute walking distance away, then there was one 4 minutes away. So I went to the different one that was 4 minutes away and the girls were like laughing at me. Like, you just bought those today? And I was like, I bought them today, but then I found them at the Rachel Cohen store in a better size. And then I have a gift card for $420 to Stephen Allen, and I almost bought a Master Gabrielle bag because I was like, what, I'm only going to spend $70 on it now to get it, because it's like when you have a gift card and store credit, you think of it not as real money, but it's real money. So yeah, that was that, and I just went to a bunch of different stores, and then I was like, fuck, I need to go buy a straightener. I was going to go to Ricky's and get one. But then I was like, you know what? The blow dry bar, why don't I just fucking do that? And I have enough dry shampoo that I can definitely make this blow dry last through Tuesday. Tuesday is when my flight's out, so last time I'm doing stuff is actually like Monday night, so Sunday, Monday, because today's Saturday, right? Yeah, oh my god, that's so doable. So now here I sit in my pod, and I'm gonna turn on CNN because holy shit, Jeb Bush dropped out of the race, which I think I already told you guys, but fuck, man, I love primary season. It is so good. It is the best reality TV there ever could be. I miss him so much on this trip. I keep calling him saying, I wanna call him right now. Where's my phone? Fuck, where's my phone? Yay. Ow, fuck. Ow. Ooh, I have a lot of texts. My cousin got engaged today, so that was super, super exciting. He proposed to his girlfriend, so congrats. Ooh, this is like a little too much, girls. Ooh, congrats to Neil and Oliva. Ryan and I were like, woo, pressure's off, because we were like, are we gonna be the ones to have to get engaged first of all the grandkids on my mom's side? Because we've been together like fucking 7 years. People were like, hey, what's going on? Is something wrong? And we're like, no, it's just not really like our thing. Okay, let's see. Oh yes, we're calling baby boy. Baby boy, you've been on my mind. Well, you might be a poker. If you don't answer, I'm gonna be sad.
Hi, you've reached the voicemail on the line. I'm unable to take your call, but please leave a message and I'll be happy to get you right back. Thank you.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
I miss you and I wanted to talk to you, but I can't because you didn't answer the phone. Bye. I leave the most annoying voicemails for people. And I also, like, I mean, I don't do it to, like, my friends and stuff. I don't even call my friends. Just always text. But to my... Well, it used to be my brother, but to my family and to Ryan, I'll just call them over and over again if they don't answer the phone. Like, it might seem crazy, but I'll sit there and be like, right, right, right. Like, I'm known to, like, if you don't answer my phone call, I'll just call you 6 times in a row. And then if you're like, what? I'm like, hey, I was trying to call you. Or if my mom pisses me off and she hangs up on me, girl, I will just call you back until you're like, stop fucking calling me. And then I'll be like, well, then answer the damn phone. And I need to eat that melon I bought because I don't got a fridge in here. Low budget pod status. No little pod fridge. What a good day. Today was an awesome day. Today is a day that like I'm proud of, and it makes me feel good about myself. Like, all of this is happening because I'm trying to like work hard and be independent and do something fun and amazing with my time that I enjoy, and it's just like one of those days that I feel like I'm just gonna be really proud and like want to tell my daughter about someday. I'm just like, oh, I go around New York City by myself exploring and I get to do all these things. And oh, also fun thing, Anomie might be in fucking Teen Vogue because nothing like that I did, but I was talking the Odette rep at Stephen Allen, Kate, was like, oh, so you're like one of the few stores that has the Metis cuff in white brass, and they use that in this thing in Teen Vogue, so we credited you as like, you know, where they can get it, so fingers crossed, we'll see when it comes out, but you guys might be in Teen Vogue. And I was like, that is so crazy, like, thank you. I can't even tell you how upset I am that this fucking hotel room does not have a full length mirror, because I just want to put on my art teacher outfit and just pose, 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 but I can't.
Okay, freakazoids. Time for CNN. I keep saying that, but then, you know, I just love hanging out with you. And please know that while it does seem like I'm speaking to you because you're watching this on a screen, how absolutely weird it is, because I really am just sitting here holding a camera. Okay, bye. I'm not gonna lie, this melon tastes like lighter fluid. Thanks, Dwayne Reed. Bye-bye, my little teddy bear, my little jetty bear, baby. I am so fucking obsessed with this jacket. I'm trying it on with all of the sweaters that I brought with me. This one is from Wilfred from Aritzia. It looks so good with my Vince sweater. And then there's the Isabel Marant sweater that I bought today. Oh my God, I'm so happy. I love my sweater. And because I'm always in put your money where your mouth is, girl, I love DeRay McKesson. I'm gonna donate to his Baltimore mayoral campaign because he's a fucking good person who's doing good things. He's one of the dudes in the Black Lives Matter movement. I love his blue Patagonia vest. I also follow his vest Twitter. But anyways, this guy's great. My Twitter is like half super fucking political shit, half like ridiculous bullshit. But I like it that way. I log on and I get like, you know, both my fixes at once. So anyways, shout out to DeRay. Not that he needs it from me. Hello, random ass white chick. DeRay is awesome. Still watching CNN. Like, I don't even want to like... Oh, bless you. It's so perfect. My wacky, wacky pants. I refer to using my Milky Jelly cleanser as I need to Milky Jelly Chelsea. So, excuse, I need to Milky Jelly Chelsea.
Hey, my name's Milky Jelly Chelsea. I enjoy scaring children and eating expired cheese.
Ah, fuck, it's this girl again. She sucks. She has kind of like talking bitch face where she looks like she's smelling shit. And she's spewing a lot of shit out of her mouth, so maybe that's it. Maybe she's just smelling the shit that she's spewing out of her mouth. So, bye-bye.
Essentially equal if you are fiscally responsible. If you're not a gap developed spring. So if somebody magically came along today.
Just staring at his little claw. Market week, day two. I'm off to Capsule and Axis and whatever else I can fit in today, but those ones are pretty big clusterfucks, so it takes a lot of time to go through it. Let's do this. Giant trade show with tons and tons and tons and tons of brands, and it's gonna take me maybe like 2 or 3 hours to go through, but yeah, it's fun here. Oh my God. I feel like Kylie Jenner needs this.
Yeah, right?
Like a matching wig. Okay guys, I just went through Capsule. I gotta admit, I'm kind of underwhelmed by fall winter 16, just in general, like watching the runways and seeing things from like new brands and stuff. I'm not really stoked. I mean, there's a lot of things I like, but there's a lot of things that I'm just kind of like meh about. So I always hate that. Every once in a while, there's just a season where I'm just not really feeling it. So it's a little bit harder to dig in and deep dive, but all the brands I carry, I still like shit. So it's all good. Now I'm going to Axis, and this is like kind of like the lesser Capsule in a way. But they have like Face and Body and things like that there that they don't have at Capsule. Alright, we'll see what brands I carry. I'm excited to smell yolk because I'm obsessed with fucking yolk so much. I think I need a snack break now. It's been a couple of hours as I look at my wrist that has no watch. Snack time.
so excited because Brew Partner is done prototyping the man penis pot and they are ready for orders. I am putting in my order today. Currently in a freight elevator that is bigger than my whole hotel room. I'm running from this side and I'm running from this side. They have shuttles, so now I'm gonna see if I can't catch a shuttle to DNA and knock that out today. Probably go to Woman. Maybe I should just go to Woman, that's what I should do. Down this long hallway.
Spoiler alert, the only good part of DNA is the view.
Pretty sure most people are just here for the food. Anyway, I'm getting out of here. That's bad. I just need to go to Woman now because I know that's a trade show that's actually good.
How sick is this office space though? Dream setup.
Here I am in the elevator going up to Brand Assembly. Praying to God it's 1,000 times better than DNA. I shouldn't be speaking negatively about stuff. It's just not my style. It was art teacher without being cool art teacher. It was literally just like, fuck art teacher. Okay, Brand Assembly is good, I like it. I went to it in LA.
I'm eating a pretzel. I found these. More.
So I think I was in there for about 5 minutes total, and 4 of those minutes was when I got pulled into a showroom by a chatty chatty salesperson who was trying to show me shit that I did not want. Wow, Brand Assembly in LA was 30,000 times better than that. And there's one brand that, like, maybe, but it was just, like, I don't like dealing, like, I don't really like dealing with the salespeople because they're, like, too salesy.
I hate to do this to you, nice jacket, but it's kind of raining. And I might be yelling right now, I don't know, because I'm listening to Serial on my iPod. So, bye. And I am back in my hotel room going over. I tried to collect like 0 line sheets and lookbooks and stuff today, but I managed to get a couple. The rest of them are all in my email. And now I need to relax because I have a fucking headache. And I think I'll probably start editing because I'm super behind on posting all my vlogs and I'm just getting more and more material and I'm like, fuck. My head hurts. Headaches from malnourishment and general disregard for human nutrition. Soylent Green. I want you to exist. And not be like gross. Be something that's like healthy. I'm gonna go to sleep so early tonight. Probably like right now. Oh, but I'm really excited because the jacket that I bought yesterday, Karen Callahan, I had actually gone to the showroom that reps her last year at this time, but it was before when the store was just online and I didn't feel confident in having like such expensive pieces and whatnot. So I emailed the girl that was like a friend of a friend, and now I'm gonna go in there and see the stuff. I'm gonna pick a scab right now. Don't look at me. Don't judge me. Oh, it's so gratifying. It's been on my heel for like weeks. It was all healed underneath. Oh, that felt so amazing to do that. Humans are gross. Now I'm gonna eat it. I'm just kidding. I'm not gonna eat it, but I am gonna throw it away. So, bye. Oh, it fell on me.